So guys, I'm gonna be making my own press to press out my one. I need to press out this bush here. That one is not too bad, that one I can just heat out, but this one here needs to be pressed in and pressed out. So I need to make a press. What I do have here, I've got a 12 ton bender. I used it for a particular job. I used it like once and I don't think I'll use it again, but I want to still keep the bender as is. So I'm gonna be using it to make a press. So I just wanna see how I'm gonna work it out, then I'll let you guys know. I gotta think a little bit. I got this piece of steel here, I've got that 12 ton bender there. So I need to see between these two stuff that I've got. Also what I got here, I actually cut a shaft here. I got a shaft here because I need something that will press that V-arm out. I mean this bush here to press it out. So this will work perfectly as a press. I need to now just make a kind of a stand. I need to think on it and then I will let you guys know what I actually decided and how I'm gonna make it. So guys, what I actually done here is I realized I cut it off here and I cut it there, then I realized I was not supposed to do that and I had to weld it back on again because I can actually do this here. So I just welded, just tack welded a plate on there, tack welded a plate on here. Hopefully it will be strong enough for this jack. I've got a 12 ton jack here, hydraulic jack. You can use any jack and just make your own press if you want to. This is just a backyard way, quick way for me. I'm working from my house and I needed to get this done quite urgent. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna, another thing is I just welded the plate, round tubing, round bar, not tubing, and yeah. So once it is more or less straight there, then I'm going to be pressing it. Hopefully it will pop out. Looks like it's working. Yep, it is working. So what I'm gonna have to do once this comes out, I'm gonna have to work out how am I gonna press my new ones in. So you can use any hydraulic jack and just think through. This is just an idea of what I've done here. I will make a proper press over time. I needed to do this. There we go, and it was pressed out, as you guys can see. Yeah, so guys, as you can see, I've got my bush C-arm kit. It's actually V-arm, but yeah, no, so I want to install this back into my V-arm. This is the new bush I'm gonna be putting on. You can see it's not, I bought it from Goldwagon, but It's not original. You can see this is the original one here, and this one is not original, but I'm hoping that quality is good, because I paid quite a price for this. Yeah, I think I paid almost 500 for the set for both front left and right bushes. So I'm gonna install this bush here, and then I'm gonna install the back one as well. As you can see, those are my two bushes there. That's the old one, that's the new one, and then this is my other bush that I'm gonna be installing. I'll show you guys how to do the installation. As you can see, my bush is in position. I'm gonna press it in here with my homemade press. This is just a simple tacking together here. This was a 12 ton bender, which I used once for one project and I never use again. So I'm literally just gonna use this 12 ton. I actually want to convert this 12 ton to a proper press where I can press out my bearings for my back wheels as well as pushes like this here. Just use it as a press. But I am within a rush, so I said I'm just gonna tack this together just to get this in here. And then the top push here, I will also change this. You just heat this out, it's basically loose, so you can pull it out and then you heat the other one in there. So that's not so critical. What needs to be pressed is this one here. So I'm gonna press this quickly. As you guys can see, I am using a 12 ton jack. You don't have to use a 12 ton if you've got something smaller. 2 ton will even work here. So with that push out, this one slips in there. There you go. And my two bushes are replaced here. I'm happy. I can do the installation. So what I need to do now, I need to remove my old bush, my old V-arm. And then I just want to wash this V-arm a little bit. It's an original VW V-arm. I got it at the scrapyard, but it was still in good condition. As you guys can see here, these holes here on my current push has slots in. So that's very dangerous, because I tighten it tight, but because of that slot, it could give me a problem in the long run. That nuts and bolts could get loose, then my wheel shakes like this here, and I don't want that. So I prefer having this here. And this V-arm, though it looks a bit old, it's original VW V-arm, should be strong enough. And my two bushes are replaced, so it's just to do the installation now. So guys, just a quick one. We're gonna be loosening this bolt here, outer tie rod. We're not gonna touch there, we're not gonna touch anywhere there, only this bolt. This outer tie rod will come out. Sometimes you have to knock it right here for it to come out, because it sometimes gets stuck. Don't hit it at the bottom of the bolt. Never ever do that. You might damage your bolt and this whole and your whole tie rod doesn't come out. So make sure of that. Then secondly, we're gonna loosen these three bolts right here. I'm not sure if you guys can see that three bolts. It's 11 millimeter spanner. It keeps your ball joints. We want to loosen that three so that this can come out from your V-arm, and then we want to loosen this bolt here as well, that bolt there, which is a 17 spanner. And then we are actually gonna come here and we're gonna loosen this too.
bolts right there, 1, 2. Get that 2 out, then your OV arm should come out. So this is the V-arm I'm gonna be putting in. You can see that bush. I just put that bush in. This is also a new bush here. Then you can look at those holes here. They are just one round hole. Now if you look at my old one, firstly, this bush here is damaged. You can see there. So this bush is a problem. Had to be replaced, but most importantly it's this here. These things have a slot in it because these bolts were not tightened fastened at the time, and then what happened, it made a slot. So as I was driving, the car was pulling to the side like this. So if ever your car just pulls to the side, first check these 3 bolts here on your V-arm. If they are slotted or they're not tightened fastened tightly, then you will have a problem. As you're driving, your car will just pull to the side, to the right or to the left. So if your car is pulling to the right or to the left, 10 to 1, this could be your problem. So check this out before you try to look at anything else. All right, so this is the main reason why I'm changing my V-arm. So yeah, so I'm gonna be putting this V-arm in. You can see it's round there. It's original, it might look dirty, but it is original VW V-arm. And then I have got my bushes in, new bushes, as I showed you guys how to press a bush in. And then I'm now just gonna quickly show you guys how to install it. The same way I remove it, that's the same way I'm gonna install it. Okay, then one more thing that I've picked up is this here. This bracket that keeps this part right here on your body, it keeps this part there on the body of your car. It's actually very bent. Look how this thing looks. It's bent out of proportion. It's actually torn here, if you can see nicely. Right there, there's a little tear there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bend this, try and bend it as straight as I can get it. I would actually love to change this whole bracket, but currently the shops are closed, so I'm gonna bend this. I'm gonna bend it right for now. Then by tomorrow I'll just go and get a new V-arm bracket like this here and install it. But what I'm also gonna do, I'm gonna weld it there way too. So I just wanna bend this as straight as possible, and then I'm gonna weld it. Yeah, hopefully it won't be too bad. Hopefully it will still be strong enough. So guys, I have actually tried to bend this thing as straight as possible. This is a very difficult thing to bend here, but I think that semicircle looks good. I have welded there, close there, you can see. I've actually welded there, there was a cut, so I welded it closed. And yeah, so my bracket looks
not nice as I would want it to be as a new one, but for now I'm gonna just use this here. As you can see, it fits nicely in there, and then I'm gonna tighten it up on those two bolts there. So yeah, I think I tried to get it to a point, even though it's very difficult, but yeah, this should suffice. I've installed my ball joint here. Just make sure that those holes line up nicely. See, mine is a little bit skew. Yeah, that should be good. So my holes, there's no slot in that holes there, which is actually very nice. That's what I wanted. Yeah, and then I got my bush in there. I showed you guys how to press that bush in. I got that bush at the end there, and then I have got my bracket that I tried to bend just to get it to a point. I might change this, I'll most probably will change this bracket, get a new bracket, put it in, but for now I need to drive my car, so I have to make a plan. Right, so all I'm gonna do now is right there is where my one bush goes in. I'm gonna push my V-arm in there, and then I'm gonna come round about here where my ball joint comes and do my ball joint in there, and then lastly those two screws that are sticking out right here, 1, 2, those two I'm gonna be using this bracket here to tighten it up. So, and then lastly, yeah, this is actually the last. Then lastly will be my tie-rod end. I will have to fasten that 19mm right here. Then that will be the last step in this process here. So I'm gonna put you guys on a time lapse, and then yeah. So guys, I have tightened up everything. This is basically the last nut I have to tighten up here. So I just quickly want to tighten this nut up here. Yeah, then I'm good. And I'm basically done. Then I have changed my V-arm. And now you guys know how to do your V-arm. And even you wanted to press it out, I have showed you guys as well how to press it out, how to press a bush out. Yeah. Just make sure when you tighten your stuff here on suspension, anything you loose on the suspension, make sure you tighten it as tight as possible, because with your car driving, shaking. Right, so that is tightened up right there. Right, my three bolts right here is tightened up 11mm. That long bolt, this one here, is actually 17, yeah, it's a 17. Just double check him. No, it's a 19. Yeah, it's a 19. It's a 19 right there. Right, and then these two here are 16mm. You can see here there's a gap between my bush and my bracket, which
It's not supposed to be like that. So reason for that is this bracket is, I had to try to bend it straight. So if I get a new bracket, it will almost probably close that gap there. But I've tightened it quite tight. So yeah, I think that would then cover your V-arm. So my V-arm installation is done. Yeah, and I made sure I tighten all my bolts tight as tight can be. Right, so now I'm done. I'm just gonna put on my tire and then good to go.